this wound, alive my heart bones. Fall back, hide yourself. I'm gone. I'm gonna wait for a long time.
We made it, Daniel. It's been a long time since I was here.
When was that?
Before you were born. Come here. Let me check you out. Claire likes everything super clean. Dad said she got pissed because he let me bring a snowball in the house. We don't want to look like total pigs.
What if they went on vacation? Or something?
We'll figure out something.
Yes, we hear you.
I'm sorry, we don't want any of...
Hello, Claire.
Sean? Oh my. Is that... Daniel?
What's going on out here? I heard...
Look who's here! After all this time.
What the hell are you doing here?
Steven, watch your mouth.
Well... It's kind of a long story.
Oh, you poor thing. You know he's sick, right?
Yeah, but...
Okay, inside. Both of you.
Hey, is it, warm enough for you?
Oh, yeah. Feels nice and toasty.
I gave Daniel some cough medicine, but you should have taken better care of him. He could have been worse. You were lucky. Steven, may I talk to you for a second?
Fuck. Did I make a mistake coming here? Oh, shit. I'm so hungry, my belly hurts.
Maybe we should call Gus.
I'm not sure it's a good idea. Do we really want to involve other people?
Well, maybe he can help. We have to do something.
Police officer was killed. Claire, you know? Our grandchildren are wanted by the police.
It's good to be inside. Finally. I just hope they let us stay the night.
Steven. Oh, Lord. Are you all right, honey? You want more tea?
Thanks. I'm good.
Well, Sean, do you want to talk about...
The police called us a few weeks ago. They're looking for you as suspects in a homicide and for assault and robbery in a gas station. Now, if you want us to help you, did you hurt that police officer in Seattle?
I don't know. I swear, I don't. Too much happened, and I'm trying to figure it out, but all I know is that he shot Dad. And now he's gone.
Oh, sweetie. We are so sorry for what happened to your father, but why did you run away if you're innocent?
I didn't want Daniel to see Dad. Like that. I felt like I had to protect him.
I understand, but...
You know the police would separate us. Maybe forever. Daniel would end up in foster care.
You can't be sure, Sean. Anyway, at least you've managed to come here alive. We're glad you two are okay.
I hate to think what could have happened to both of you. You need to think of long-term solutions now.
I tried. I swear. But I can't do everything.
So, what are your plans?
I'm trying to figure it out. I just want to watch out for Daniel. Wait for him to get better. Before we take the road again.
How can you look out for your brother if you're both running from the police?
You two are gonna stay with us.
Oh, Steven. Maybe we should...
After your mother left, your dad never really wanted us in your life. I can't blame him. But you're still part of our family, and we want to prove it, okay?
Whoa, really? Aren't you scared? The police already called you.
Lordy, yes. But we were also scared for you.
That's why you'll have to be careful around here. Beaver Creek is small and nosy.
We can stay? Serious? Awesome! Ooh, Sean, guess what? There's a huge model train upstairs.
Hey, you're supposed to be resting, young man.
Yeah, yes he is. But he seems better already. Anyway, you and Daniel will stay here. At least until Daniel's better. We'll see what happens next. So, I bet you're hungry. Let me fix you something.
How do you feel? Superwolf?
Way better. It's nice and warm in here. And the food? Yum.
Yeah. Feels good.
Feeling better? You look cozy.
Yeah. I love that bed. Thanks, Grandma.
Good. Your temperature is down.
I'm way better now.
You still need to take it easy.
How about if we say a little prayer and give thanks?
It's like a bedtime story, right?
Well, this is a bit like this, yes. Except the story comes from up there.
The ceiling.
So are we ready to pray? Just follow my lead.
Sure. We need all the help we can get.
Can you ask the blessed dad? And Sean. And Mushroom. And you and Grandpa. And, everybody else.
Oh my, you are so sweet. Thank you, Lord, for bringing Sean and Daniel safe and sound into our house. Take care of Esteban and, Mushroom. Please, give us the strength to get over the hardships of the past and the trials yet to come. Amen.
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 Okay. It's bedtime. Try to get some rest. You still need it. And no roughhousing in here.
No worries. We're too tired. Good night. Oh, and thanks again.
Good night, Grandma. Feels so nice to have a bed again. And a bathroom.
I hear that. Plus, you don't smell anymore.
Whatever. Well, Claire seems pretty caring. And nice. I guess Steven is too. I hope we'll be fine here.
I think so. And the more important thing is you'll have time to get better.
Sean? Are we in Mom's old room?
Nah, I don't think this is the one. Not from what I remember. But it's been a while.
Could we check it out tomorrow? Maybe find some of her stuff?
Why would you want to do that?
I just don't know anything about her.
Daniel, I understand. But we need to focus on where we are now and where we're off to. Mom left us. She made her choice. We gotta make ours. And we can't keep going back. You know what I mean?
Yeah. I guess.
Hey, man. You've been doing so great with your... Well... You know. I was wondering... How do you do it?
I don't know. I concentrate and it just happens.
Wait. Does it hurt?
Nah. It's kinda itchy though. And exhausting.
Sorry. Anyway. Remember the rules, right? We really don't want Claire or Stephen to start asking questions.
I know. Don't show, don't talk.
Just keep that in mind and everything should be fine. Sleep tight, little cub. I could sleep all day long in this bed. But I'm way too hungry. That's cool Claire dug this up for us. Dad's such a baller in his suit. This is pretty good so far. I love that Steven only has crime and train books. All right. I'm allowed to go out now. Daniel looks like a total thug in his new pajamas. That's a cool memento of our secret cabbing in the woods. Thanks, Claire, but I will never wear these things. Daniel was training his precision with ease. Fucking awesome. Yep. Daniel knows how to milk Grandma for toys. Good. He deserves to be spoiled.
Sean! Finally.
Sean, are you awake? Breakfast's almost done, so come down when you're ready, okay?
Okay!
Choo-choo!
Oh, careful, Chief. They're going too fast.
We have to. We're late on schedule.
Yeah, but we're gonna scare the passengers away.
I don't care. Faster.
Better hit the kitchen quick. Claire's waiting for us. What's up?
Ah, look who's here. But you're too late for the 9:15 express.
It's okay. I'll take the next one.
It will leave after breakfast. Don't be late this time.
I won't.
All aboard!
Better not sneak in. They won't like it. Fuck. I broke this thing like 10 years ago. I can't believe they fixed it. And kept it. It's been locked ever since we got here. And I kinda don't give a fuck. Oh, man. how did we survive for weeks out there with no hot water? I used to hate brushing my teeth, just like Daniel. Now I can't get enough toothpaste. Wow. They sure did stock us up on clothes for the winter. Hope I'll never have to hold on to a bar to take a shit. They have so many pills and stuff to take. Sucks to be a- It's crazy how everything is neat and tidy here. Quite the change from our last home.
And watch out for any train hoppers.
It's weird. Sometimes I feel like we're complete strangers. Which we kind of are.
Careful! Tunnels ahead! Hold your breath! Whoa! We made it!
Steven doesn't like us in here when he's away. Man, Claire's food smells so good. I'm starving.
Oh my, look who's awake.
Daniel, breakfast time. Your brother is ready.
Grandpa, show me your pop star.
Steven. Your grandson needs to eat now. You can show him the boxcar later. I love how they're getting along.
Do you need help or anything?
Oh, don't worry. I can do this in the dark. But thanks for the offer.
All right.
Are you boys done playing?
We had an express delivery with the passengers. But the engine broke down.
Yep. Has to go straight to the workshop.
Good. No trains in the kitchen, remember?
Gotcha, Chief.
Choo-choo!
Oh, sugar. He can fix his trains, but... not my kitchen. Did I make enough? Everything's okay?
It's great. As usual.
You're the best cook ever.
Looks like you're getting cozy with this new country life after all.
Yeah. It's nice to be far away from everything. Feels like we're the only ones out here.
Well, that's exactly why we love it. It feels safe, unlike the big city.
I get it.
I like it. It's cool here.
Well, bless your soul. You'd get along good with our neighbors. We try to lend a hand, like to Charles next door. He lost his wife, and things have been hard on him and his son. He would just get lost in Seattle. But we're all taking care of him here.
How old is his son?
I think he's your age.
Ooh, cool.
Hey, what's going on back there?
Nothing.
Oh, I thought Stephen was a fast eater.
Hey, Grandma, I wanted to ask you something about that locked room upstairs.
I told you there is nothing to see in it, Daniel.
Why were you in it this morning, then?
Because there's a lot of old junk in there. And besides, it's not safe for you to explore, okay?
But we'll be fine.
Why don't you go explore outside? You sure look like you're getting better. Get some fresh air.
I'll wait for Sean, and then we'll go. We won't be loud. Promise.
But be careful nobody sees you. Stay in the back, okay?
Maybe you should tell him that it was Karen's room.
It's just a room now, Sean. Nothing to see.
Daniel needs that. He doesn't know anything about her.
I know, poor thing. But his mother isn't in there anymore. So nobody goes in the room, okay? I'm serious.
Did Mom ever contact you? She only talked to Dad a few times. Then she was gone.
Yes, she was. You know, Sean, I don't really want to talk about this anymore. It's over. Anyway, you have to respect my rules under my roof. Okay?
Of course. Always.
I appreciate that, Sean. Now you better go find your brother. There's a shed with some old toys outside. I'll bet Stephen has the key.
Danny, old freak. Thank you. Clean kitchen equals clean conscience. Claire could totally be on one of those cooking shows. She would be brutal. Yeah. Pretty different from the one we had back at home. It's cool that Claire does her little paintings. I wonder where this was taken. I don't picture Claire and Stephen as world travelers. Where was that picture of you guys on the beach from?
We went to Hawaii when Stephen retired, believe it or not.
That's so cool. I could totally see you surfing. Did you love it?
Well, it was too much paradise for me. I think Stephen could have stayed.
Dad said Puerto Lobos was like a mini paradise.
Of course he would. That doesn't mean you'll think that.
We'll see. I miss Dad and his silly Santa Gringo accent. Whoa. Look at all these decorations.
So, are you excited about the tree, Daniel?
Of course I am. When do we start?
I'll get it this weekend. Promise.
I heard Claire rehearse some songs. She's got the groove.
Sorry for getting upset, Sean. I just don't feel comfortable talking about all this.
I'm glad I picked these up. Gives me something to work on when they're all watching TV. It's fine, really. We don't have to. Hey, Claire?
What's on your mind, Sean?
Do you know anything about Dad's funeral?
There was a service. We couldn't make it in time, but we sent flowers. I'm sorry, Sean.
It's okay. I just want to make sure somebody took care of him.
Hopefully, you can go visit him at some point.
At some point? Yeah. What did you think of Dad? You can tell me. I won't get mad.
Well, your father was... he was his own person.
That's it? I mean, I know you guys didn't really get along.
It's just... Esteban was very different from us. And he never took a single step to change any of that.
Sounds like Dad. He wasn't one to smooth things over.
Trust me. I know the type. But he did raise you boys on his own. Can't argue with that.
Yeah. He worked his ass off for us. Wish I realized that sooner.
Don't worry, Sean.
How long have you and Stephen been married?
Oh, my. Forever. But a good forever. Almost 40 years.
Man, that's more than twice my age. You both were married during Y2K.
Thanks for making me feel even older. I assume you must have a girlfriend or...
I almost started dating this one person. But I guess... not anymore.
I understand. I'm sorry, honey. It's not fair that you have to deal with all this. Things will change.
I hope. What's the story with your neighbor?
Charles? Oh, poor man used to be a basketball coach, but had to move out here after his wife's passing. He's got a job at the rail yard now, and... well, he's still recovering.
Wow. I mean, that's sad.
We tried to give him a hand, keep an eye on his drinking problem. His son Chris is a little angel, though. I think he could be a good influence on Daniel. This boy has spent too much time on the road.
Yeah, and I'm not always the best role model. Well, thanks, Claire.
You are very welcome. It's always a pleasure to speak with my grandsons.
Such a big fireplace. And not even needed. That's luxury.
You had a dog?
Yes.
Feeling of love.
Polly left us 3 years ago.
Passion princess?
She's still with us.
Escape to pleasure?
Is she in heaven?
Man. Does Claire read all these?
Of course she is. But she's in our thoughts as well.
That's nice.
I better catch...
Hey, I want to be in your drawing.
Oh, don't draw me like this, Sean. I'm a mess.
Don't worry. I'm drawing the whole room.
Good. It's so nice
cool.
to see you practice.
I think I'm ready to draw this.
You're so passionate.
I'm not moving. Hope I look good.
Time to take the pen, dude. Okay. Got it. Pretty good. But I can add more details if I want. I need to train my visual memory. Oh, this looks cool. Too bad it's broken. What happened to the ship?
Oh, that thing? Steven made it years ago. But it fell, and he doesn't know how to fix it.
That's sad. Looks pretty... Tried one of Claire's books yesterday. It's basically a telenovela with white old women.
Thank you for tidying up a little. It's nice of you.
Yeah. No problem. Have you ever seen any actual fish in there?
Never.
I haven't seen any actual fish in there since we got here. Finally, some friend.
Think I need a handy assistant. Can you hand me the glue in the cupboard behind me?
Sure.
Whoa! Careful. Sorry, I forgot. That thing isn't too stable. Let me just...
Okay. Sorry.
My fault. Your grandmother keeps telling me, but I'm a lazy old man. Hey, can you close the door? I want to talk for a second.
Oh.
It's the power cable, of course. Yeah, it happens all the time. So, listen, I've noticed things with Daniel. You know what I'm talking about, don't you?
Not really. What things?
Well, I'm not sure how to put it. Like, some kind of invisible force. The holy gift or something.
Yeah. Daniel likes to pretend he's got superpowers, but that's it.
That's it? Okay. But be careful, Sean. You know, he's still so young.
Sure.
And by the way, let's keep this between us. Claire has a lot of strong beliefs. She wouldn't understand. She adores Daniel and just wants both of you to be safe and happy. What I'm trying to say is, maybe you should stay here with us. I know you boys plan to run to Mexico, but...
We have a home in Puerto Lobos. Dad wanted to return there. Two Mexican boys out on the run? That won't be a secret in Beaver Creek for long.
America is your home. With us. And you have to think about your brother, you know, his future, all that stuff.
It's too dangerous for us to stay here. And for you guys, too.
it's dangerous to be on the road. Do you think your father would have wanted this for his kids?
Of course not. But everything's different now.
I know. Well, just think about it. But don't torture yourself.
I will. Hey, Claire said you had the keys for the tool shed?
Oh, sure. Here. You guys enjoy the sun. And be careful with that shed. It's probably a mess inside.
Thanks.
It's good to see you in my lair. You know, you were...
How come you have a disco ball? Are you, like, throwing parties and stuff?
No, this is a souvenir, you know? I actually met your grandma during a disco night. Believe it or not.
Claire told me you guys have been married for, like, 40 years, so... It kind of makes sense.
That sure was a long time ago, but we stuck together, you know, through thick and thin.
That's cool.
Well, call me old-fashioned, but I think that's how marriage should be. Found this. I just forgot to,
It's okay. It's been a while since I've seen her face.
Yeah. I like taking a look at it from time to time.
Doesn't it hurt?
Yeah, it does. But she's still my daughter, you know? I can't approve what she's done, but I think I understand.
Good. I don't.
Yeah, I'm sorry, Jean. Please don't... please don't say anything to Claire about this, okay?
Don't worry. I won't. Steven sure takes his hobby.
I'm sorry, Sean. I know you guys miss your games and your websites. But trust me, a break from all this can only do you good. You know, and it's safer that way.
Yeah. I know. Man, who did this?
Oh, it was our neighbor's son, Chris. Yeah, I helped him and his dad build that treehouse.
Why are you holding a fire sword?
I'm not sure. You know, that kid sure has an imagination.
Wow. Is that you?
Yeah, that was taken when I retired. The mayor came to congratulate me himself.
That's awesome.
Yeah, really great day. I wish you'd been here.
Ah, there you are, Sean. Got the key? Hey, I have to go out and run some errands. Can you do me a big favor? Do you know how to work a washing machine?
Since I was about 8.
Of course. Can you throw in yours and your brother's clothes after the next load? They're in the bathroom basket.
Totally, yeah. No problem.
Thanks so much. Feel free to keep on tidying your stuff, too. It's good for the health to keep the house clean.
Definitely. Daniel can help.
Ah, and remember, for your own safety, no phone and no internet. I know. Boring rules.
Don't worry, Claire. Hey, Daniel! There's work for you!
busy my ass. Come over here.
You gotta find me first.
I don't know when Daniel will be able to go back to his school.
Jeez.
What's even the point of having so much crockery? This is fun every once in a while, but it gets old every other night. As always with Claire, I can't really tell if this is cute or bossy.
Gotcha!
I get that he's sick of all this shit, but why are we playing this game? Can't believe it's already been a week since we got here. Oh. This used to be Karen's room. Wonder what they've done with it. I know you're in there.
Gotcha!
What the?
Behind you!
Yeah. Very funny. No more hiding. Seriously.
Okay, okay. What do I have to do?
You tidy the mess in our room, and I take care of the laundry. Cool?
Again? We always have to clean everything. I don't wanna.
Yeah, I hear you. Never mind, okay?
Cool. Thanks, Sean.
All right. Time to take care of that laundry. Thanks, Claire. Come on, man. I've put all your toys in the trash, dude. Of course not. But next time you bail on me, maybe I will.
Sorry.
We stopped our training session since we got here, so... sucks. It's so weird to be back here again. Claire and Steven are kind of weird sometimes, but they do care about us. I'm glad they're spoiling Daniel. Wish I could. Dad never really got along with them, though. I barely know them. Family, right? We're safe. That's all I need. All right, let's get it over with. Next step, wash. How many programs does this thing have? Okay, it will do. Okay, time to burn off some calories. What do you say?
Haha! Yes! Oh, man, finally! Feels so good to be outside. Reminds me of the cabin. Right?
Oh!
Watch out for the pack.
Daniel seems so happy to be here. Good. This place is actually kind of nice. Wonder what it's like in the summer. So that's the treehouse Steven helped out with. Pretty awesome. Get ready for storage wars.
What's wrong?
Frozen shut. Of course.
Sean, look! Did you see that?
See what? We just got here. Are you okay?
Yeah. I didn't see anything either.
Okay, I just fell down into the snow. Dad says I'm kind of clumsy.
That t-shirt is wicked. Who's your favorite superhero? I love Power Bear!
Oh, man! I have the Mega Power Bear. You should check it out.
Dude, that's so cool.
Chris, oh, God. Look, I am so sorry. Are you okay?
Dad, I'm fine. I promise.
Are you sure? Listen, I shouldn't... Do you know them?
It's okay, Dad. They're cool. He loves superheroes, even Power Bear.
Ah, gotcha. Hey there. Are you staying with the Reynolds?
Yeah. But not for long. We're just passing by.
I see. Oh, geez, Chris. You don't have any damn shoes on. I'm sorry, buddy. Let's get you inside.
Yeah. Okay, Dad.
Thanks, guys. Oh, and, if Claire asks, tell her everything is fine.
Is it really?
Never mind. See you around.
Sure.
Thanks, guys. See you later.
Yes, we will.
Daniel, did you forget everything about the rules already?
Sorry, Sean. Did you want me to let him fall? Really?
No, you... You did the right thing. But listen, we can't let anybody know. We have to keep a low profile out here.
He's like my age. I bet you would have done the same exact thing. Don't be mad.
I'm not mad, dude. It's over. Daniel, remember that we're hiding out. So no training and no showing off your power. From now on, you stick with me all the time, okay?